Thanks for joining us. Joining me in the studio today is Talktime English Coordinator Molly Makrogianis and AmeriCorps member with Project Citizenship Casey McLaughlin. And they are here to talk about really all the citizenship initiatives that we have going on at the library coming up very soon, right?
Yep.
Welcome. Thank you for being here.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you, yeah.
Molly, why don't you start out? Can you tell us a little bit about the Citizenship Corner?
Sure. So about a year and a half ago, the library received a grant from the Library Board of Commissioners, and we've been able to use part of that funding to set up a few more citizenship initiatives at the library. So one of them is a Citizenship Corner, which is an area on the first floor of the library mm-hmm. where people can go to get books and materials when they're interested in preparing for the citizenship exam. Mm-hmm. It also has an information bulletin board where we post flyers that where people can find out where local classes are happening if they're interested in taking an actual citizenship class.
That's great.
And we brought along one of called the toolkit put out by USCIS, the U.S. Citizenship and Information Services.
And this is a toolkit that they can check out with their library card,
is that correct? Yep, so this is one of the things that they could find in the Citizenship Corner. And this one is just a very comprehensive set. It includes a DVD, the books, flashcards. So you can take those things out separately, or you can get them all in the kit to take home and use to study.
Very helpful.
Yeah, so there's lots of good resources.
You also have a computer in that corner as well, is that correct?
Yep, so we also set up a computer a few months ago that's dedicated just to the USCIS website. So again, this is the U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services Department. So on that website, there's tons of good information about the naturalization process. Mm-hmm. There are test prep materials, so you can actually sit at the computer and do some studying. Yeah. You can also download the application and print it at the library.
Can they submit the application online from that computer, or?
No, but they are able to print it and then take it to fill out.
That's great.
Yeah. Awesome.
Anything more about the Citizenship Corner?
No, the Citizenship Corner at the main library is up and running, so people can visit that anytime. And we are in the process of setting up another corner at the North Quincy Library.
That's great.
So that will be up by next fall. So we think that'll be a really good location for people who are interested in that neighborhood.
Yeah. And this is ongoing. This will be here permanently, correct?
Yes. And, we'll keep it supplied with lots of good textbooks and information flyers and really kind of everything people need to find out about the process, how to study, and where to go to get more information.
Now, on top of that, you're also offering a citizenship study group. Tell me a little bit about that.
Yep. So currently at the library, we have a conversation group program that's mm-hmm. for people who are interested in practicing their English. And sort of through some of the feedback of our students, we've learned that a lot of people are interested in more specific help preparing for the citizenship test. Mm-hmm. So this spring we started what we call the Citizenship Study Group, and that group meets once a week on Wednesday mornings, mm-hmm. and we have two great volunteer teachers who are doing a really good job presenting lessons for people that are completely focused on the civics questions, the interview questions, just everything people need to practice to get ready for their test.
How do people join the group?
So people can join just the same way they join a conversation group, which is through the Talktime office. So they could email me or call me if they're interested for more information. We always post information about when our actual registrations are coming up. Uh-huh. So people could also come to a registration and sign up either for a conversation class or for the study group.
That's great. And what's the contact information they can reach
you at? So my email address is quenglishtalk@ocln.org. Mm-hmm. And my phone number is 617-376-3295.
Great. Anything else about the Citizenship Study Group that you wanted to talk about?
No, we're just happy that in addition to, I know that there's a local organization, Quincy Asian Resources, that mm-hmm. has a class, that this is just another opportunity for people who are interested in seeking out an actual class to help them get ready, that we're able to offer that at the library as well.
Awesome. And Casey, on to you. Welcome to the studio.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about yourself and how you became involved with AmeriCorps and Project Citizenship.
Sure. So I joined Project Citizenship as an AmeriCorps fellow last September. Mm-hmm. I actually met them at a career fair at my school before I graduated. Mm-hmm. And now I'm a part of their organization, and their mission is to help every permanent eligible permanent resident in Massachusetts apply for U.S. citizenship. Mm-hmm. While there's over 300,000 permanent residents who are eligible, only about 10% apply. Mm-hmm. Due to a number of factors, the cost, language barriers, intimidation and fear of immigration. We try to help remove those barriers so that everybody has access to the benefits of citizenship.
Great. Great. So you will be having a workshop that's going to be held on June 23rd in the atrium and the meeting room.
Yes.
It's pretty big. Tell us a little bit about that.
Sure. So we are an organization based in Boston, mm-hmm. But we have community workshops that we hold in other communities around Massachusetts as well.
Okay.
So we'll be coming to the library on Saturday, June 23rd, where we can help you fill out your entire application for citizenship. Start to finish, we'll have it ready to send out at the end. We have attorneys who are there to quality control applications, answer any questions that you have. And then if you submit an application with us, we'll be your representatives throughout the whole process that can help you with any issues that might come up or to advocate on your behalf if ever necessary.
That's great. Now, are you looking for people to pre-register or can they drop in?
We welcome people to drop in if that's the most convenient for them. We do highly encourage you to give us a call beforehand, mm-hmm. Because if you show up, we'll have to screen you on the spot. Whereas if you call us in advance, we can take maybe 5 to 10 minutes, answer a few questions, and then have you registered and all your information ready to start the appointment when you arrive.
What's the number that they can contact you at?
You can call Project Citizenship at 617-694-5949.
Is there anything else that you'd like to mention about the Project Citizenship Workshop?
Yeah, I would like to emphasize that it is free. It mm-hmm. is of no cost to anybody attending. As well, about 75% of our clients are eligible to not even have to pay for their application. So the federal filing fee could be waived as well if you're receiving any public benefit like MassHealth or food stamps. Mm-hmm. So I would encourage you to call us if you think that you might be eligible. The basic requirements are that you're 18 years old and that you've had your green card for at least 5 years or 3 years if you're married to a U.S. citizen. Mm-hmm. And apart from that, there's a lot of things that people might think make them ineligible when in fact they are eligible. So if you have ever had any past criminal cases, any travel issues, we can evaluate that for free if you give us a call and let you know exactly what your eligibility stands, where your eligibility stands.
Sounds great. Casey, what are some of the benefits of citizenship?
Well, first and foremost, citizenship is permanent. So once you become a citizen, you never have to renew a green card ever again. You can't be deported. That status is permanent. Mm-hmm. Of course, you can vote in federal, state, or local elections. Mm-hmm. You can run for elected office. Mm-hmm. Citizens have priority when petitioning for family members to come to the United States. So if you have any parents, children who you want to come, the process is immensely faster if you're mm-hmm. petitioning as a U.S. citizen. Not to mention you can travel freely without any restrictions with a U.S. passport. If you have any children who are under 18 and have their green cards as well, they'll automatically become citizens once you naturalize as a citizen, making them eligible for all sorts of federal financial aid if they mm-hmm. choose to go to college. U.S. citizens, on average, earn higher wages and experience lower poverty rates than permanent residents or people of any other immigration status, and that's regardless of race, gender, or any other factor.
Thank you both for being here today.
Thank you, Brian.
Thank you.
If you'd like more information about the Citizenship Corner or the Citizen Study Group, contact Molly Makrogianis at Quincy Talk Time English. And the Project Citizenship Workshop will be held on June 23rd from 10 to 2. If you'd like more information about this event or any event sponsored at the library, please visit our website at thomascranelibrary.org.